And it's a real pleasure to be here in Alvin, Texas, recording an album or so and talking to you wonderful people. Even though I told you I was born in Louisiana, I still love to come to Texas, I guarantee you. That's for sure. Now, I got a few stories I want to tell you. You know, by profession, I'm a safety man. You know that? You look at me and told I wear both a belt and suspenders. I don't take a chance. Not long ago, I got a friend named Wayne Picou, who lives down south from me about, 18 or 17 miles. In an area what we call the Bear Island section of Maripo, swamp down there. And he got a grocery store and he works hard, but he loves to hunt too. And one day, one of them city slicking Cajuns from around Baton Rouge or someplace like that say, "Wayne, you know you ain't never asked me to go squirrel hunting with you." This was this last September. Wayne say, "I ain't never asked you to go squirrel hunting with me." He said, "That's right." He said, "Well, how come you don't go squirrel hunting with me?" He said, "Well, I'm glad you asked me. I'll be glad they did that." Wayne said, "We can't go now, the season's closed." He didn't tell him he'd been going by himself, you know. He said, "The season opened two Saturdays from now. You met me at my house before daylight, and we'll go hunt them squirrels." He said, "Okay, I'll be there." Two Saturdays from then, 2 a.m. o'clock in the morning, beep, beep, beep. Wayne go out there and say, "Who the hell that is this time of night, huh? Blowing a horn like that." The city slicking kid said, "Well, you told me to get here before daylight, and I'm here." Wayne said, "But hell, I didn't mean for you to come yesterday." He said, "You're here. Come on, brought yourself on in. We'll make some breakfast and some coffee, and then we'll go get them squirrels." He said, "Okay." So he brought himself in there, and he made some coffee, and he made some breakfast. And they wait a little while, and they get in Wayne Picou's Jeep because the roads ain't them good there in that swamp. And them frogs are just giving it a going over, you know. And they get in them Jeep, and they go to the end of the road by the Black Lake Club. When I'm talking about the end of the road, all you can hear and you can't see is them frogs just raising hell, and they wait till daylight. And it's been dry, but not too dry. When daylight brought itself, this fella from Baton Rouge, them Cajun look out there and say, "I ain't going in that swamp and hunting no squirrel, no." Wayne said, "Well, you got to. You can't get them on the highway, on the road." He said, "I ain't going there." He said, "How come you ain't going?" He said, "Must be 10 million, at least 10 million snake in there. I ain't about to go in that." And it was hot weather, and he was telling just about the truth. Maybe missed it one or two snakes. Wayne says, "Look, there ain't snake number one in there." He says, "You crazy?" He said, "No, I ain't. I guarantee there ain't snake number one." They say, "How the hell can you guarantee something like that?" He said, "The alligators done had them all up."